Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an Allen Bradley processor PLC5. This is an L80E. This is the Ethernet platform processor. So what we're going to do is we're going to test the ability for the processor to go into run mode and sustain itself in run mode. We're going to check for errors and we're going to check that the Ethernet port is working. So that's what we're going to do today. I have it being powered up by a 1771 P4S power supply, and the four slot rack that I'm using is a 1771 A1B. That's a four slot chassis. So the first thing I'm going to do is open up my RS-Lynx Classic Lite, and this software is the communication path software between the computer and the processor. So what I'm going to do is open this up, go to Communications, RS Who, and the RS Who screen pops up. It shows my workstation and any processor attached to that workstation. Now, in order to link up to it, I'm going to hit the Configure Drivers icon, which is that squiggly line with the two computer leads at each end. I'm going to click that. And the available driver types, well, this is the RS-232. So if I hit the drop-down menu, if I don't already have a driver configured, I'm going to select the RS-232 DF1 devices. And once that's selected, and in your case maybe added as new, I'm going to select configure. My configured devices window will pop open. And you'll notice at the top left-hand side it says COM ports, COM1. Make sure that whatever COM port that you are using for this test is properly selected. And then go ahead and hit Auto Configure. And it's going to go through all the different configurations, baud rate, parity, stop bits, device type, station number, and just check to make sure everything's right and or put it in order. We call it a cheat button. So once it says auto configuration successful, I'm going to select OK. Now a little note here, it's always okay to continue to open up RS-Lynx or enlarge the RS-Lynx Classic Lite window just to make sure that you are still running. There are situations during downloads where you could in fact go offline and you'll need to reconnect, so it's always okay to keep checking that. Now I do recommend that you just reduce this screen and do not shut it. You won't have a connection if you don't do that. Next thing I'm going to do is open RS Logix 5. This is the software for the L80. And I'm going to go to File, left-hand corner, and select New. And the window that pops open, it allows you to select the processor type that you want to test. So, under Platform, out of all the selections it has, original, enhanced, protected, Ethernet, we're going to click Ethernet. And then the processor type, just to the right of that, is PLC580E. And then to the right of that is the series. I happen to be testing a Series E, so I'm going to select that. And if you don't know what revision it is, it won't really matter because the software will correct it anyway. I believe that this is an F, but I'm just going to go with the default B right now, just as an illustration to show you. And select OK. Just as an illustration to show you how the software can intelligently select the proper rev, firmware rev. Okay, so now that this is an Ethernet, we want to select an Ethernet address that we're able to ping this with so that we can test this port. So we're offline right now, but we are connected. So what I want to do is double click on channel configuration on the left hand side, and I'm going to go to channel 2. If you guys can see underneath of this transceiver port for the Ethernet, it says channel 2. Now once I go to channel 2, the window's going to have a bunch of information that's grayed out that you're not able to edit. So on the left-hand side, about halfway down, it says Network Configuration Type. We want to select Static. And then the IP address, subnet mask, and gateway addresses, they all open up so that you're able to edit them. And what I'm going to do is select a IP address that is above and beyond, or a number that won't conflict with anything else that we have running here in our network, and same subnet mask that everything is on here too. So you select a number that works for you, that doesn't ping any other devices in your network, and then at the bottom you can click apply, and once apply is grayed out you can click OK, and that window will disappear. You're ready to download now. Now, one other quick tidbit is under channel configuration, under channel 0, which is what we're connected through on the RS-232, you do have the option before you download, if you like, to change your baud rate, and you can change it to 19.2K, or up to 19.2K, which is a fast communicating speed. In this particular case, just because I'm just testing this as an example, I'm going to leave it at the default 2400, but just know that that's an option if you do want to speed things up. Now I'm going to go to my offline button and click the drop down, and it's going to ask me if I want to go online now, download, partial download. We're going to select download. It's the middle selection. And we're going to start to see some windows pop open once this is selected. First one is, naturally, as I said before, it's correcting me, telling me that this isn't really a Rev B, it's a Rev F. And do I want to change the data tables, to resize the data tables in order to stick with what the processor actually is? And I do, so I said OK. The other thing you might get, I'm not going to get in my case because this is a test unit of mine that I've already tested through the Ethernet, but if you're changing the Ethernet address in the processor, it's going to let you know that it's different, and do you want to go ahead with the change? And as long as it doesn't conflict with anything, you will need to go along with that change and select yes or OK in order to test it, in order to get it to download properly. So if you see that, don't panic. It's okay to change it. You can always be changed again. Just make sure that you're not, when you are trying to ping the Ethernet portion of this device, that you're not actually pinging something else on your network, okay? And I'll show you how to test for that too. Another little bit of information is, as you can see, a lot of my test units, I don't always use a battery. In this particular case, I recommend that you do use a battery, because if and when you do change the Ethernet address, it may ask you to power cycle. So you want to make sure that you're backed up with a battery that's going to hold that IP address in there while you power cycle. So always have a battery when you're testing the Ethernet module. All right, save program as, in this particular case, it's PLC L80E test. So I'm going to select a name for it that I can keep as a PLC L80E test. And I'm going to save that. And then it's going to ask me or you if you want to go online. Yes. And you'll notice that the status bar on the top left-hand side that did say offline now says program. And you'll also see a ladder with some green, pink, and blue squares revolving. If it's revolving, it's telling you that this is all communicating and talking. If it stops and says that the processor's gone offline for some reason, that reason could be if you've changed your baud rate. You simply open your RS-Link's classic light and just hit auto configure one more time, and it'll get you back on track again. Okay. All right, now that's in program, I'm going to go ahead and put this in run mode by going all the way to run mode and then back to remote run. It's not really necessary to use the hard run, as we call it. Remote run is fine. On my software, I have a remote run, which is illuminated in green. There's no faults, so I know that all the configurations I've done are correct. And what I want to do now that it's in remote run mode is a couple things. First, pertaining to the processor, I'm going to double click on processor status. And you're going to get a window that pops open with tabs at the top. And I'm going to scroll over to the right to errors. So I'm going to go from main to MCP, scan times, math, switches, errors. And I'm going to check to see if there are any existing errors in this processor, or what it's telling me, if there's something wrong with it. If there's something that's wrong that's not a huge deal, I might hit clear major errors, or I might write down what it is and look into it further, depending on what it is and how big of a problem it is. And then you can go to processor warning, which is the next tab, program warning, channel warning, and you can get some information from these different tabs in the event that there is actually something wrong. It gives you some sort of a diagnostic feedback. All right, so this processor is totally clean. No problems or errors. And then that leads me to the next thing that I want to do, which is test this Ethernet port. And I'm going to do that using this device here, which is a transceiver. So hopefully you guys can see that. My Ethernet cable plugs into the back, and this plugs into the front of the processor, channel 2. We're going to put this in here now. Okay, now that's firmly connected. And then I'm going to connect to it with I have a local Ethernet cable that's plugged into our network. Plug this in the front. Next step is you have to be online, or at least using a wireless Wi-Fi, and you want to ping it. So you go to your start screen, go to your command prompt, and then hit the function you want to do is ping space and then the Ethernet address that you've selected, and hit enter. Okay. And what you're waiting for here is you're wanting a response from the processor. It should ping it 4 times and give you information on how quickly it responded to that, and what the speed is in which it's communicating. As long as you get 4 clear responses, then the Ethernet card is working properly. Now, to test to make sure that you haven't just pinged another device on your network, simply take your Ethernet cable out and go ahead and ping it one more time. And of course, what you're looking for is that you don't get a response at all. Of course, if you do get a response, then that means you were pinging another device and you'll need to find a different address. So in this particular case, I wasn't pinging anything else. The Ethernet is working perfectly and I can remove this. So that's pretty much the whole test. What you might want to do in case you think that this is a problem processor is you could, in fact, fill the slots with other devices, I/O type devices, if you like. You can block the path of air to put the processor under a little bit more strain, give it some more heat, put it in a situation where it may end up going into a little bit of a struggle. And what you're trying to do is to see if the processor kicks itself out of run mode. All right. And what I normally do is I'll keep the processor running for a couple days, 2 or 3 days, maybe over a weekend, and come in and check on it and check the diagnostics, as I showed you before, the processor status. I'll check to see if it's still in run mode. If it's kicked itself out of run mode, I might want to go into the errors and find out why, see what the problem is. But generally, if it stays in run mode in a moderately strenuous situation for 2 or 3 days, we feel that it's a good working processor, typically. If you do have a problem that's beyond what you're able to figure out, this is something that we do repair quite regularly here. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.